It's a pleasure to be here today, and thank you, Senator Frockton, and your son, for reminding us that this is a very special day. As a witness, as someone who learned a story, I will hope I can do justice to it. But I've had a longtime friend I worked with 30 years ago in Mason County, and a mechanical engineer. He started a company called Techwood, and over the years has employed hundreds of people, and is an outstanding gentleman. He's now about to turn 92 years old. He still goes to work every day. He was there this morning and then traveled back to Olympia here where he lives. His name is Arnold Zweig, Z-W-E-I-G. And if you Google Arnold Zweig, you will watch an interview as I did on Friday night. I didn't know that he had told me his story, but I didn't know what the details. If you watch that, I was riveted for a little over 2 hours listening to him, his recollections of growing up and what happened in Danzig, where they lived, where the war started in 1939. It was a free city in Germany, but part of Poland, basically. And he and his family were moved to a ghetto. And that ghetto, I think, was in Lodz, if I'm pronouncing that right. About 165 people in the ghetto. They got a loaf of bread every 8 days. Tremendous hardship. He lived in an apartment house, and some people were so weak that they would just make their way to the top floor and leap off. What a situation. What a way to be 11 or 12 years old. And the rationing continued. He had his bar mitzvah in a ghetto. Then they were informed that the Russians were coming, so we have to relocate you to a place deeper in Germany. And in August 1944, his father, mother, relatives were taken in a boxcar. 97 people packed in a boxcar. No food, no water. Finally, they arrive. The door opens. They're in Auschwitz. People falling off the boxcar. Mass confusion. He asks a fellow with a striped shirt, an inmate, where am I? What is this? What is this? And all he says to him is, say you're 18. What do you mean? Say you're 18 years old. And as the lines form, and his mother goes to the gas chamber, he's intercepted. And what does he say when the SS officer says, how old are you? 18. And he goes into the other line. The other line that eventually survives Auschwitz and another camp. And finally, the 101st Airborne Division comes. And that night before they came, the guards all disappeared. When they woke up that morning, there was no more guards. And Arnold talked to people and said, what? Who is this? It's the Americans. And Arnold told me, he said, how could they be here? That's across the ocean. That's across the ocean. How could they be here? He was completely cut off for all those years from any news. He didn't know anything about the Russians, knew there was a war, certainly, but didn't know. Well, Arnold is still here, still with us, still telling his story, which is so compelling, so compelling. And just can't say how happy I am to know him, to be his friend. But we have to remember what happened. And today, a lot of events are happening, obviously an impeachment and a death of a sports star. Lots of things are happening. But this is a very, very special day, that 75th remembrance of the Holocaust. So thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you.
for me stumbling through these remarks. It's just a pleasure to be here and represent this individual.